Hi, Assalamualaikum and good day everyone. I am Miss Fatima. In this video, we're going to discuss on subtopic 3.7, which is hypothesis testing for the ratio of two population variances. In the previous video, we have learned how to test the hypothesis for one population variance using chi-square test, right? So in this video, we're going to test the hypothesis for the ratio of two population variances using F-test. So, the parameter of the hypothesis testing is sigma square for population 1 over sigma square for population 2. As usual, there are three types of tests, which are two-tailed tests, right-tailed tests, and left-tailed tests. For two-tailed tests, we're going to reach a hash null if F-test is less than the lower limit critical, the lower critical value, which is F 1 minus alpha divided by 2 with degree of freedom, nu 1 and nu 2. Or we're going to reach a hash null if F test is greater than the upper critical value, which is F alpha divided by 2 with degree of freedom, nu 1 and nu 2. For right tail test, we're going to reach a hash null if F test is greater than the upper critical value, which is F alpha with degree of freedom nu 1, nu 2. For left tail test, we're going to reach a hash null if F test is less than the lower critical value, which is F 1 minus alpha with degree of freedom nu 1, nu 2. Next, the test statistic for this hypothesis testing is like this, which is F test is equal to S square 1 divided by S square 2. Where S square 1 is the variance for sample 1 and S square 2 is the variance for sample 2. Okay, now we proceed to example 3.9. A manager in a large computer operation company wants to study the use of computer from two departments within the company. The departments are the human resource department and the research department. The usage time in seconds for each job is recorded as follows. Okay, so the first question, is there any difference in the variability of usage times of computer for each job from the two departments at alpha equal to 0.05? The variability here is referred to the variance. So the question asks, is there any difference in the variability in the variance of usage times of computer for each job from the two departments of alpha equal to 0.05? Let's say we denote human resource department as the first population and the research department as the second population. So we want to test whether the variance of first department is any difference is not equal to a variance for the second population. This is the claim. Okay, so this is hash null or hash 1? Since this is not equal, so this is hash 1. So hash null would be the variance for first population is equal to the variance for second population. So it will be like this. Hash null is a variance of first population equal to variance of second population. This is hash 1 is equal to the variance of first population is not equal to the the variance of second population. So the claim is a difference in the variability. Okay, so next step is to find the test statistic. So in this case, our test statistic is like this. We use F test. So the formula is the sample variance for population 1 divided by sample population for sample variance for population 2. So to find the sample population sample variance, you can you just key in into the calculator and get the sample standard deviation and then square it to get the variance. So for first population, you get S1 is equal to 3.2711, and for the second population, you get S2 is equal to 3.1464. So S square 1 is equal to 3.2711 square divided by S2 square, which is 3.1464 square. You get the test statistic value, which is 1.0808. So next step, you need to find the critical value. So in this case, this is two-tailed test because our H1 is not equal. So we're going to find the the critical value for the lower critical value and the upper critical value. So for the upper critical value, which is F alpha divided by 2 with degree of freedom nu 1 nu 2, is equal to 0.05 divided by 2, and nu 1 is n1 minus 1, which is 5 minus 1 is 4, and nu 2 minus 1, 6 minus 1 is 5, is equal to 7.3879. But for the lower limit, for the lower critical value, is f1 minus alpha divided by 2 with nu 1 and nu 2. So it will be f0.97545. So from the table, we don't have the table for significance level for 0.975. So it is equivalent to 1 over F0.025, and then we swap the degree of freedom 5 and 4, so you get 1 over 9.3645, and you get the critical value, the lower critical value, which is 0.1068. So we are going to reject H-null if the test statistic is less than this one or greater than this one. So in this case, the test statistic, which is 1.0808, is less than is between the lower critical value and the upper critical value, where it falls in the acceptance region. It lies here, 1.080808. Therefore, we accept H-null, or we do not reject H-null, or we fail to reject H-null. As a conclusion, at alpha equal to 0.05, there is insufficient evidence to support the claim. Therefore, there is no difference in the variability of usage times of computer for each job from the two departments. Now, for the second question, the director of the company has agreed to upgrade the computer processing time in the research department if the mean processing time of the research department is greater than the mean processing time of the human resource department. Is there enough evidence to support the director's claim at 5% level of significance? So from the question, it wants to test the hypothesis whether the mean processing time of the research department, which is the mu 2. This is the second population, this is the first population, is greater than the mean processing time of the human resource department, is greater than mu 1. So this is the claim. Okay, which is H1. So H-null will be mu 2 is less than or equal to mu 1. So our hypothesis will be like this. Okay, next, for the next step, we're going to find the test statistic for this hypothesis testing. So based on A, our variances are unknown, right, for the two population, and our conclusion that there is no difference of variability for the two population. Therefore, the variance for the two population is equal. So and our number of sample is both are less than 30, so we need to use t-test. Okay, and then you just substitute all the information into the formula and you get the test statistic, which is 0.3610. And then since this is right tail test, and then we're going to reach a hash null if the test statistic is greater than the upper critical value. So in our case, the test statistic is, which is 0.3610, is less than the critical value, which is 1.8331. So we fail to reject hash null. So conclusion, at 5% significance level, there is no enough evidence to support the director's claim. Now you can try exercise 3.7. There are three questions of them. If you have any questions regarding this topic, you can ask your respective lecturers and try to solve it together. Okay, that's all from me. Thank you. Bye.